Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Today we are back with Shikha Makhija ji again, and today she's going to teach us about Rahu and the doshas. So I was very interested when she was explaining with certain examples. So, and she also has a presentation today as usual and with a lot of examples as usual. So welcome, madam. It's a long time after the lockdown. We are again together. And the background is also very interesting. So I also had the same background.
That was the last time we had the same thing, and many of the comments had come in, like, y'all are using beautiful backgrounds and all that.
Yeah, and whoever is watching this, before we start, madam also has a YouTube channel, and she has some amazing guests. Could you please name some of the guests you have invited?
Yeah, so YouTube channel is Shikha Maharaj Makhija, by the name that. And there are most of the videos that I do are with guests like you yourself, then Pai sir, Satyanarayan Nayak sir. He's a great personality in Nadi. There is William sir, a very great astrologer. That is what we feel. Dinesh sir, always predictive astrology is his best part, and he gives small tidbits about only predictions, how to do predictions in astrology. He's having those classes, amazing classes on predictions. This is there in your chart, and this will happen, and this it will happen at this time. Final. That is it.
Interesting.
So those are, yeah. So all these guests like that. There is there was one Lal Kitab person also, one runes person also, numerology also, my friend. All those videos are there. So people can go and check them out.
Yeah, please check them out. Her videos are really interesting, and you also have a website, right? And you also do consultation. So I will give all the details, and whoever is interested to get a consultation from her, please do not hesitate to go to the link, and I am sure you would love it. All right, so stage is yours, madam. All over to you. Please.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Let me share. Okay, so please give me permission for sharing. You need to give me permission for sharing.
Okay, I think maybe I can make...
You can go to participants, and there you allow share.
Okay. I think I'll give you the host. I'll make you the host, then maybe you should be able to... Because I don't see that option here. Yes, there you go.
So today's topic is about Rahu in Nadi. Now in Nadi, Rahu and Ketu are called as destiny breakers. Means these are the two planets which we, everyone in astrology, say are connected to our karmas and everything, birth and rebirth and death, moksha and everything. So these two planets become the destiny breakers, in the sense, like, these two planets cause obstructions, delays and everything whenever they are combined in some combination, in some yoga and everything. Now in Nadi, we have very simple, like, suppose Rahu is combined with Sun. So then Sun plus Rahu, that we call as Panchama Dosha.
Pancham dosha, okay.
Dosha. 1 minute. Let me share the work. Okay. Yes. So Panchama dosha. Here, Sun is the natural lord of the fifth house, representing children. Yes. But in Nadi, there is a special Karak Tattva given to Sun.
Okay.
The Karak Tattva is of children. It is not Jupiter. It is given to Sun. Okay?
Yes.
So, Panchama Dosha. Sun plus Rahu create a Panchama Dosha. What does Dosha give or how does it manifest is like these people have difficulties in begetting progeny, especially the male progeny, male child most of the time. And in many charts I have seen that even if they have children, then either the children have some health issues, or they are not staying together, or the native and the child does not gel well together, means the happiness from the children is not there. That is what, and it works in literally all the charts. Here I have put one chart. I will put only one chart for every this thing today, because otherwise it will become a big lesson. People can go and check on their own in many, many charts. Of course, there are many riders, like people, most of them will say, oh, we have Sun and Rahu, but we have children, we have a male child. Of course, the whole chart has to be seen in totality. We have to see the fifth lord, fifth house and everything. If everything is damaged, then this works. But still, there is some other issue. Okay. Yes. So this chart that we can see is Oprah Winfrey's chart.
Okay.
She has Sun and Rahu over here. Okay, so we all know she is not unmarried, and she does not have any children. She had only one pregnancy, and that there was a miscarriage or something. So a clear case over here. Of course, the Sun is very badly damaged in her chart over here. So first we have to look at the Sun. The dignity of the Sun also has to be checked. Straight away, people should not say, you don't have children, you don't have this. No. Maybe the child is there, but they are staying apart. Maybe the child is there. Father goes out, travels a lot, and does, matlab, his work is such that he stays away from the own children. Maybe like that also.
Okay.
The native. So this, then same way we have, if we have a moon Rahu combination. Okay, so it is called as a Chaturtha Dosha, because moon is the lord of the fourth house. And fourth house is Chaturtha, that is fourth house. So this is Gandhiji's chart, Mahatma Gandhi chart. There is a moon Rahu combination over here. So the mother has some health issues, some problems. So when we go to check in Wikipedia and everything, the mother was a very frail person and did not keep good health. Okay, there is nothing written about his relationship with his mother, but such people, such natives also have trouble with relationships with their own mother.
Okay.
So, like, as we know, Rahu is illusions, and then they create many, many illusions about their own mothers. Maybe she has done or not done, we don't know. But people have those illusions that mother has done this and this to me. Therefore, there is some problem in their own relationships with their mothers. And mother always have some health issues if this combination is there. Okay? Mm-hmm. So the next in the line is Mars Rahu combination. It is called as Ashtama Dosha, because Mars is a natural eighth lord, and this is the worst of the doshas of Rahu.
Okay.
Here Mars, we already know, is exalted in the 10th house, and if you know a little bit of Vastu, then Mars is a Dikpala Yama Devta. Devta given to Mars is Yama.
Okay.
And Rahu is the Kala.
Okay, yes.
So the combination of Yama and Kala.
Oh,
So always death-like situations and too many accidents. That too very sudden. They always like more to do with weapons. Mars is also all weapons in Nadi. Each and every weapon is denoted by Mars.
Okay, is it? Okay.
Yes. Even a small needle is Mars.
Okay.
Okay. So here, there is a trinal relationship. Last time, as I told you, the trinal relationships are very, very important. Indeed.
Yes.
There is a trinal relationship with Mars and Rahu. And Rahu is sitting in Mars house. This is a chart of Angelina Jolie.
Okay.
Okay. Now, when we study about her, she is in her childhood, though she came from an affluent family and everything, in her childhood or the teenage, she had tried to do suicide 2-3 times by cutting her wrist with sharp objects.
Okay.
She was very fascinated with all the weapons and blood. When she got married, she just wore a white t-shirt written with blood or her own blood that I'm going to marry you or whatever, I love you, whomever she married, like. You know, and then the second marriage, they exchanged the blood of each other. They put it in a vial and they used to wear it all the time. Like, she was really, like you can say, blood and weapons.
So here, even though Mars and Rahu are not together, but because Mars and Rahu are in trines, you would still consider them as being
the,
in Ashtanga.
The conjunction has, yes, okay. Conjunction is always there. And because it becomes very strong, because see, your natural eighth house has gone over here with Rahu sitting over.
Okay, got it.
It becomes more distinct. And she has so many tattoos done on her body. So all that sharp weapons, 22 tattoos, I think I read that. 22. I'm not sure about the number, but what I remember is 22.
Interesting.
So this is really, and if Saturn also comes in this combination, then it is really death-like situations many a times in their own distinct life. Okay?
Just.
Yeah. So, just by looking at the combinations, so you can just ask the person, has this happened to you? Is this a problem you have? Or say, suppose we get a chart, I'm not getting children or I have problems. So first thing I'll see is where is Sun and Rahu is placed.
Okay.
It is so simple. Okay. Then Mercury Rahu. This is the Bhrata Dosha. Bhrata means brother, third house. Mercury is the lord of the third house.
Okay.
Correct? So this can also signify that maybe there are problems with your younger brother. Okay. He has some younger problems in his life. Because Mars is a younger brother, and then any sibling younger to that younger brother is Mercury.
Oh, okay. Okay, got okay. It.
So maybe that, but this Mercury is also the planet. Like in Nadi, we take it for attraction towards each other. All the boyfriends, girlfriends come under the Karaktatva of Mercury. Any types of friends are Mercury.
Oh, is it?
So, Mercury Rahu will give you attraction to the opposite sex, maybe affairs and all that.
Mercury Rahu also.
Mercury Rahu.
Okay, interesting.
So, again, we have Oprah Winfrey. She also has Mercury Rahu over here only.
Yes.
So we also she has so many relationships. If you go to read, you will find it. Okay. And the second chart I have put is of the great actor Rajesh Khanna.
Okay.
So we know about him also. Here also there is Mercury and Rahu in Trine.
Uh-huh.
Okay. The next one is Venus Rahu. This is known as Kalatra Dosha or Saptama Dosha also. Because Saptama, because seventh lord, and Karaka of marriage also is Venus. So whenever you have the Venus Rahu combination, it is one of the beautiful combination because it is Guru Shishya combination also. And it is also the combination which can give you riches. It is called as a Nagmani Yoga in Nadi. Because Rahu is the Nag and Venus is all the gems, money, Nagmani. So, though these all the above combinations, the Sun, Rahu, this and that, they'll give you like non-materialistically, they can give you a lot. But the problems in the living relationships and all that.
Okay. Inner happiness could be missing. That's what I understand.
So your marriage problems.
Okay.
Chosen marriage, married life, not happy. And that is why it is called as a Kalatra Dosha. Seventh house is also called as Kalatra or Saptama Dosha. Okay. So this is a chart of Indira Gandhi ji. So she has Venus Rahu and we know about her married life. Firoz Gandhi stayed most of the time, he was staying away from her, maybe because of work or whatever the reason is. Okay. And the last one today is Saturn Rahu. It is called as Pitru Dosha because Saturn is a Karma Karaka. And Rahu in Nadi astrology are the great grandparents.
Okay.
Our forefathers, Pitru.
Okay.
So this combination is a very beautiful combination. Whoever has this combination, I have seen in many charts, they take responsibility of their elderly people, of their grandparents. They look after them. And unki seva, they, you know, they give service to these elderly people. And once they do this service, na, it is a beautiful remedy for their own chart. I've seen people who have this Saturn Rahu combinations. If they are taking care of their parents, grandparents, or elderly people working in old age homes, then they achieve too many good things in life.
Oh,
dosha is mitigated. This is the beauty of this. So most of them will say Pitru Dosha hai. Go and do this. Go do this remedy. This is why you're suffering. Nothing like this.
We also the call this Shapit Yoga, I think.
Shapit. You just have to go and take care of the elderly people. That's it. Okay. So here I think this is a chart of Sharda Devi. She was a wife of Maharishi, I forgot his name. And she did too much of meditations and all that and was well versed. And she took care of many, many people even after her husband died. And, you know, like she became a mother to so many people around her. But this is what has happened.
His wife of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa.
No, not Ramakrishna. Maharishi Yogi.
Okay.
Yeah, Yogi. Okay. So I think it's a very simple session, but Nadi is really simple if you go to think about it. So I hope people can use this and check on their charts and even I have just told a remedy of Saturn and Rahu. Same way people can do remedies about the other planets.
Yeah, that's the beauty of Nadi, you know, very simple, very straightforward, cut short techniques.
If it is Venus Rahu, so take good care of your wife.
Okay.
Keep her happy. Like that, simple remedies are there.
Okay, so now here, because in Nadi, I think the Mars shows the husband, if I'm correct.
Yeah, Mars is the husband.
If a lady has Venus Rahu, then in that case,
because Venus is a karaka for marriage, both for male and females.
Correct.
Still, her married life is spoiled.
Okay. I got it. Thank you very much. It was indeed very enlightening in the sense that such simple rules, and you can speak so many things about a person's life. You know, just by seeing Rahu and the times from
Correct.
Yes. Thank you so much, madam. And I'm sure we will record soon again.
Thank you very much for whoever
made it till the end. For them, please go and check our videos and our channel again. I'll put them down in the description section, and there's some amazing content there. And Siyam Sudha's consultations, you'll also find the website link down in the description section. Okay, until next time, see you again.
Thank you very much, Babjiti. Thank you so much.